Okay, off layer.
Oh man. Oh, that went really well.
Dude, Jason, it was fucking fantastic having you.
Yeah, that was fucking awesome. I didn't even think we would go that long. That's awesome.
I know. Thank you for I didn't know if we kept you on too long, man. I hope we didn't.
No. It's fine. It's not a problem.
Okay, cool. Yeah, we definitely got to do this again sometime, you know? I know Don Tony talked about it on Monday a little bit and stuff like that.
Yeah, no, that's awesome. I actually, on the way home, it was funny because I said, let me listen to a little bit of what you guys, and you were on the show last night. And I said, let me give it a listen because I want to just see what you guys were talking about. So it was cool. I heard that you got to plug the appearance on there. So that was nice.
Yeah, no, absolutely. Because it was pretty important.
Yeah, you know, it's funny.
You know what I forgot to bring up? God damn, I feel like an asshole. What? Joey, did you take a look at Stitcher?
No.
Solid Monster is number one in sports right now. And you bounced all the way up to number eight in all fucking shows, man.
Are you serious?
Dude, you're beating out, like, Kevin Smith. You're beating out a shit ton of people, man. You're right behind the Serial podcast.
Whoa. Let me see here. I find that hard to believe.
Fan-fucking-tastic.
Let me take a look.
That podcast was basically like the... that was like the awakening of people to this thing that that Serial podcast. I'm pretty sure I said this to you too. I'm like, our numbers probably rose over that time just because of that podcast. Yeah,
no, absolutely. And the,
holy shit,
dude, it's fucking crazy, man. That is awesome. No idea.
Oh, I'm glad you brought that to my attention. I looked at the list last week and I thought it was cool. It was your show and Don Tony and my show and Caban. It was like wrestling, you know, they're at the top of the list. And then I didn't think anything of it. And that's fucking amazing. I can't believe that.
See, I'm going to have to leave this in now because I feel like a complete asshole for not bringing that up. I thought that was fucking amazing.
Huh. Now I'm happy you said it.
Missionary's like,
we do the show, goes off the air. He's like, by the way, I forgot to bring that up.
Fuck. Missionary's like sitting there. He's like, all right, so we're going to just make fun of things. Oh, here's something that might be really important.
Yeah, I know. Up. What a dick.
Here's some actual great news.
Yeah, I know. Dude, well, I'm fucking, it's awesome to see you up there, though. Seriously. You know, we were joking about it. We've been joking about it. It's just crazy that wrestling shows have been beating out CBS football shows, you know, on any fucking medium right now.
Yeah, no, I mean, it's incredible. It's funny, too, because they had the, it was a couple years ago, they had the Stitcher Awards. I don't even know if they do them anymore, but we got nominated, and then if you looked like the sports top finalists, you had my show, and then it was like CBS Sports. It was all football.
Yeah.
And I knew at that point, I go, we're doomed, that's it. Like, we'll fucking do the same exact thing. We'll fucking try, but like nothing. And of course, like CBS Sports won, but it was kind of like an aberration there. But it's always like the fantasy football stuff and basketball sometimes. So, but I didn't know like the main. Yeah, there it is. Look at that Serial.
Yeah, they still have a big shindig every year down in San Francisco, and we went up there. What was it now? 2013, right, Joey?
Yeah, it was 2012.
December 2012. Yeah.
Yeah. Whatever. And we went out there for that too, and it was just, we were like, oh, this will be fun. And then just listening to like the nominees, we're just like, oh my god.
I know. Yeah, here. Sports Illustrated, ESPN, CBS. Yeah. It's like, are you fucking kidding me? Yeah. I mean, at this point, you start feeling like Wayne's World, you know? We're just doing the show in the basement. You know?
It's like, what am I doing here? Like, am I in the right place?
Showing.
It's like millionaire. It's like millionaire company, billion dollar company, billion dollar company. Two guys with headsets. It's like, oh, this seems fair. Yeah. This seems like a reasonable competition.
Yeah.
It's like best audio producers in the world, and
well, look, if nothing else, I still have the audio bite from when I made it to the finals, and they had this woman, the Grammar Girl, who apparently has this big podcast herself where she talks about nothing but the English language, I guess, which sounds so exciting. So they had her. They had her, of all people. They have this woman doing the intros. I don't know maybe it was for all of them, but like for the sports category. And I'm like, she's going to mispronounce my name, like the name of the show. I know she's going to mispronounce it. And she's going through the shows. And finally she goes, she did it like in the form of a question. She goes, Solo Monster sounds off? Like she was And I'm like, you know, I am taking that. It's at the end of every show I do now. It's at the end of my outro every single week. It's like priceless.
Yeah, we had Mark Maron who he said it with like the state of confusion as if the guy could possibly give a shit about sports and or wrestling.
But that wasn't even the most depressing part. The depressing part was when they rattled off all these CBS companies, the ESPN shit. It was like a smattering of applause. And then all of a sudden, when they mentioned Wrestling Soup, we heard a bunch of people cheering. It's like, who the fuck are all these people?
And I'm just standing there like, I'm right here. Yeah. Come say hi.
Tall guy in the back.
Yeah, no. Well, nobody. I really think that, especially in that area of the world, they just think everybody is like thin, attractive actor type.
Oh yeah.
So they couldn't possibly imagine it's like giant Asian man and short little Italian guy standing in the back. Oh, those guys are on air talent. That must be it. No, yeah. It's like how did these two homeless guys get lost?
I know, we were wearing suits. Weren't we all suited up and shit? And we're sweating our asses off. It's in the middle of December in San Francisco. And it was like 90 fucking degrees.
Yeah, I went through the trouble of like putting on a shirt and tie. And I walked in there. It's like dudes in drug rugs. I'm like, oh, my God.
I know. And lady's like, can we take your coat for you, sir? I'm like, oh, yeah, fantastic. And I'm like, see, Joey, it's going to be all schnazzy and shit. And we get in there and it's just like, just anthrax t-shirts and ripped jeans. I'm like, what the
I'm like, I could have worn pajama pants for this.
Yeah, shit, man.
I probably should have. So you didn't miss too much there, but dude, at the top of the charts, how fucking crazy is that? Yeah,
that's wild. No, I'm gonna post about that when we get off. I just had no idea.
No, it's fantastic.
For once, news is good news. Yes. Usually,
that's right. Fuck NPR. I'm four spots ahead of fucking Joe Rogan down here. Look at this.
Right? That's fucking awesome, dude.
God. Wow. Well, the amazing thing is, as far as like Joe Rogan is concerned and his whole podcast, is if we all owe him a debt of gratitude.
Yes.
That's basically it. Like the whole entire medium without Joe Rogan at this. Like people talk about Adam Carolla, but it's like, yeah, whatever. Okay. Like
he didn't affect as many people as Rogan did. No way.
No.
Rogan had a wider reach. I mean, far wider reach than Carolla did.
Yeah.
No, yeah. Without Rogan, his consistency and his range of guests, we'd all be having like 600 people a week listening.
Right.
It would be the same 600 people too. There would be no revolving door. It would just be like the same 600 people. They would all listen to the same podcasts, and they would all be terrifying to speak to.
You know, Rogan's story is kind of fucking funny too, because he was supposed to be one of those Sirius XM guys, and I don't know exactly what happened like contractually, but that's what caused him to pretty much flip everybody off, flip off terrestrial radio, and go to podcast. And then that really opened up the medium for everybody, which is just kind of amazing. And now radio, honestly, is holding on by a fucking thread. You know, me and Joey constantly talk to a couple of radio guys, and they've all been shit canned.
Well, that's like years ago when a lot of the radio stations got blown out by that whole Jack FM. Remember that whole thing?
Yeah.
I mean, it's kind of the same thing. I mean, a buddy of mine, I mean, he's on the show sometimes. He's a radio guy. He was in the same boat. I mean, he got shit canned because of all that stuff that was going on. Now he's doing traffic for like a different radio station.
Yeah.
I don't think he has the same like radio credentials that he had before.
Yeah.
Like it's rough. It's really rough.
It's horrendous to try and be in actual terrestrial radio these days. That's why I'm just kind of happy that the podcasts are kind of taking off now.
Yeah.
It's like, you know, if it really wasn't for some of these guys, you're Joe Rogan's and shit like that. I mean, he makes a living off of this. You know what I mean? And that was another thing I wanted to hit up. I know it's so left field, but it really pisses me off that Vince Russo and Stone Cold Steve Austin, ask for donations for their fucking podcast. It's like you're a fucking millionaire. What are you asking for donations for? Get the fuck out of here.
Yes.
Steve Austin's like, I need donations so I can buy another house.
Yeah.
You got a fucking ranch that he owns.
I need to buy three more cows. Like, what the fuck, dude? You're so rich. Why are you asking like just an average dude probably making 40 grand a year for money?
I know.
Like, really? That's you're asking them for money? Like, that's so fucking silly. You're Stone Cold Steve. These guys need to either realize they're doing it because they want to do. If they're doing it for money, they've lost their shit. They need to realize that they're doing it for either the entertainment value, the brand value, or something. Because
yeah, but I think it's a podcast one thing, though, because like a lot of them, like Jericho does the same thing, and they always say, if you want to keep the show free, you know, click my Amazon banner, do this, do that. But it's like the same thing. Jim Ross, too. It's like a podcast one thing. So how much of that is them? But I agree. I mean, it looks bad when you have these guys that are fucking multimillionaires five times over, basically begging people to, you know, buy their fucking lawn chairs using their Amazon link. I mean, it doesn't sound right.
Izzy Vince Russo, he's like, hi, I haven't worked on a legitimate day for the last 20 years. Can you just give me money for nothing, please?
We ripped the shit out of him because he went on like a 5-minute rant about why you need to donate to his show. And we played the whole fucking 5 minutes on the show and just ripped it to hell. It was just, you have to buy my show because you're only listening to 1 hour here. You're missing the 3 other hours I put on every fucking day that have the real content.
Yeah. What does he call his thing? He has like a name for it, like the brand or something. Is that what he calls it? Right. Because I see that stuff on Twitter sometimes. Like, oh, look, the $2.99 to join the brand. And I'm like, who the fuck would pay $2.99 to listen to this guy? I tried to – he did an interview with King Kong Bundy like a month ago, and I'm like, oh, all right. You don't really see King Kong Bundy doing too many interviews, so I'm like, maybe I'll check out part of it. I got through like 5 minutes of it. I couldn't take it. I couldn't – he's like, bro, come on, bro. And I'm like, I'm going to blow my brains out if I don't turn this off.
He's like that Rob Lowe commercial.
It was like, who could tolerate like just the free version, let alone who are these people that are paying for like the videos? Right. He does videos, and I'm like, what the fuck? But what, he's not, what's he going to do? No one will hire him now.
For $2.99, I'll stop saying bro.
But you know, the biggest problem is with doing interviews, and one of the reasons why, even though I kind of want to slowly implement a few more interviews into it, just because it's good, because you know, you, it helps you plug your shit, it helps them plug your shit, it's right. Good for them, it's good for you, whatever. But like, the hardest thing with interviews now is the stories have all been fucking told to death. What wrestling fan wants to even hear Bret Hart talk about the Montreal Screwjob again? Yeah. Would if you were sitting there and someone was like, hey, here's a clip of Bret Hart talking about the Montreal Screwjob. Do you want to watch it? Wouldn't you be like, no, I think I'd rather just smash my head against my refrigerator.
Part of the problem is that it's really nothing we haven't heard before.
Right.
So, you know, what do you say to them? Like, you know, they're going out, they're doing interviews, they're trying to make something happen. But you could do an interview with anybody if it's not compelling or funny. Or if you don't give people a reason to listen to your show, they're not going to fucking listen.
Well, yeah. And the response to that, and this goes, there was a – fuck, who was it? There was somebody that just – they dug up. There was an interview with some WWE guy. I forgot who the fuck it was. But they literally dug up. Like, we haven't heard of him in forever. And it's either going to be an interview where it's supposed to be shocking – so they ask all these horrible fucking questions. Like, what was the last time you finger banged your daughter? And it's like, you know, it's these douchey, horrible interview shows. Or on the other hand, it's a lot of safe shows. Here, let me ask you something that's completely open-ended. We don't want to offend you in any way. We don't want to ask you anything that pushes the envelope in any way. And that's what you get. It's very hard to find somebody that can actually sit down with somebody and really, you know, I mean, not always. There's always, you know, the rare one here and there, but a lot of the interviews fall into both of them. I mean, you can even listen to the Stone Cold podcast, Chris Jericho. They do the exact same shit. You know?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah. No, that's you're right. And they kind of like, it's like sloppy seconds. They share the interviews. It's the same people. That's why I said, when I heard Russo had King Kong Bundy on, I'm like, fuck, I haven't heard King Kong Bundy's name in a while. So at least that's compelling. Now, if it was anybody but Russo, I would have listened to the goddamn thing.
Yeah.
And also, you guys need to get King Kong Bundy on your show.
Oh, and let's also take into account King Kong Bundy is outspoken.
Yeah.
His shoot interviews are hilarious, which I'm the epitome of a shoot interview whore. I will watch just about anybody's shoot interview. To make me turn off your shoot interview, you have to be so fucking atrocious. Like, it has to be mind-blowing. I came close with with Brodus Clay's shoot interview. Oh my god. What a pompous dickhead.
Yeah. Didn't he say something about Hornswoggle? I heard he went off on Hornswoggle.
Oh, yeah, he said something. He was all, he's always fucking with me. He's trying to fuck with me. And I'm like, yeah, he's fucking with you because you're an asshole. You're a fucking jerk off. You know what I mean? He's on. He's doing U shoot, and then like people are asking him very. It's U shoot. They're asking just a marquee ass questions, and he's like, "What kind of shit is that?" And you're just like, dude, what business do you think you're in? Yeah. Really? Yeah. Like,
you guys
want
some cool stats?
Hmm.
We missed over 132 calls.
Whoa. Wow.
We had over 700 live listeners. To get 700, that's fucking insane.
Oh, by the way, Mish, are you recording?
Yes.
Okay. That's my question that I ask him usually. That's usually my question when a caller is atrocious.
Oh, yeah.
No. I say that to him when somebody calls on the line and they're really bad. I go, Mish, are you recording?
Yeah. I mean, I'm just saying.
Yeah, 132 calls, though, man. That's a lot.
Yeah, that was quite a bit of people fucking missed, but yeah, that's good though. Absolutely, thank you.
Well, they'll get a no. Please, it was a lot of fun.
We're actually trying to do something for YouTube now too on Mondays, some 15-minute fucking thing pre-record. But
yeah, and you got that thing on Saturdays. I heard now.
Oh, the Saturday morning shitbox. Yeah, that's,
yes, great name. That's got to be on a T-shirt.
Well. Well, you got to understand what happens is whenever I'm left with the choice, Missionary named the show Wrestling Soup because God knows if it's up to me, it's going to be something really terrible. So he's anytime he's given the option for me, some random person on the Facebook page said, well, what do you want to name the Saturday show? And we'd been answering voicemails for about 2.5 hours. And he just says to me, well, how about somebody said Saturday morning shitbox? And I just lost it because I was just sitting there for 2 hours, and I'm like, that's perfect. Let's just call it the shitbox.
Oh, dude, if you listen to it, I swear to God, it's like an ADD on crack. That's what the Saturday show was. And you want to hear something more fucked up, Joe? We've already got 30 voicemails now.
Oh.
30 voicemails. It's not even fucking Thursday yet for Saturday.
No, hey, I feel your pain. Look, I got two separate email addresses. I got the one I use for the show, and I got a personal Gmail. So I have it set up where when an email comes into the show one, it forwards to my personal one, just so if it's something important, I can respond quicker if I have to. So I've been fucking way behind now for the last few months, really, on emails. I mean, last I checked, I think I had 3,600 unread emails in my inbox. But I was always good about, at least cleaning up my personal one because I didn't want that to be flooded. So at any given moment, I got like 30 like personal emails in that inbox. And the last 2 months, for whatever reason, it's just out of control. And now my personal inbox is up to 687, and I'm swamped. I gotta go through it. So
Jason.
I know it's
and how many of them are just like, hey, what do you think about CM Punk?
I would say if I had to venture a guess, well, I would say out of the 687, if I had to venture a guess, maybe, I don't know, maybe like 150 to 200 or like that.
Hey, what do you think about this?
Hey, you have you heard respond. CM Punk went on Colt Cabana's podcast?
I'll get an email like 4 days from now. Hey, I heard you're going to be on Wrestling Soup. When's that going to be? But it's the thing is, like, a lot of the questions, it's not like a simple one word answer. Like I can respond, like okay, like a yes or no. It's like, if you had a fantasy book WrestleMania, okay, from scratch, only with guys above the age of 32, how would you do it? And it's like, I can't answer this. I can't.
It's just the most complicated, convoluted question.
I've always deleted those emails. I hate to be that dick of a guy, but on the Facebook or whatever, I always delete those questions every fucking time. Yeah. It's like, who would you fuck, marry, kill in the history of the universe? What? Fuck out of here.
You see it and they're like, so if it was 2004 and you could make Chris Benoit the champion, how do you build the Mexicools lawnmower? What?
If you could go back to June of 2007, what would you tell Benoit before he did what he did?
What would you say to Chris Benoit? Don't.
don't fucking do it. How about that?
Please don't.
But every now and then I will get a gem. Like I talked about it on my show this weekend, where in the subject line, the guy is like, you better answer.
Oh, I listened to that. That was fucking funny.
Those are the ones that just make me smile.
You better answer.
And then the whole email's in caps. And they came up with a new word. They referred to me as scumnut, which is a word I've never heard of before. I might start using it in my everyday lexicon here.
Now, is this actual fans of the show, or are these just fucking people that randomly hate?
I mean, that doesn't happen often. My guess is this guy is not really a fan. I mean, he may have listened to one, or he may be a closet fan, but he just wants to hate.
I got you.
It's not like I constantly get emails like that, but that's what makes it special when I do. I just, you know, I can out them and post a fucking thing on Twitter and then, you know, point and laugh because they're brain damaged. So,
well, he was, you know what? He was just looking for the response.
That's the whole thing. He wanted a direct response, so I figure I will out him. He may not even know that I did that, for all I know, but I'm not going to directly address him.
Right.
Yeah. So, yeah. It's like when your dog is doing something shitty, you can't acknowledge it. No. Sometimes you just gotta just be like, hey, I'm doing this. You're just like, no, if I acknowledge you, it will just encourage this behavior. You know, I have to just let this just die out, because then you can't get some of that yummy, delicious attention you're seeking.
That's right.
That's right.
That's what all comes
shit,
down to.
You beat to. Time?
What?
Damn, he beat time.
Did I?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to look at this when we get off. I haven't even looked at the rest of it.
Awesome, dude.
Yeah, there it is. Time's the brief. Wow.
Jeez. All right. I think it's about time for us to hit the road.
Yes,
I mean,
absolutely.
Price, but we will absolutely do this again. That was a lot of fun, guys.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. And that was, and from the reaction I'm seeing so far, everybody seemed to enjoy it.
That's good.
All right. Awesome.
We're happy that they enjoy it and not calling for our fucking heads or nothing.